All right, guys, here we go. Another video here. This is a retaining wall we did last year in South San Francisco. I wanted to get the drone up. This would have been a beautiful drone video, but San Francisco Airport was about a mile or 2 miles away from it, so it would not allow me to take off. Hope everyone's doing well. Staying positive. Remember, it's cool to ask for help. Hang around people that's positive, and if you wake up with good intentions, everything is going to be all right. This one here is pretty straightforward for us. It is a pier and gray beam system here, and we did pour monolithic. We kind of figure out how to pour these walls monolithic. Ideally, you have three separate pours. You have the piers, you have the gray beam, and you'll have the wall. But we poured everything monolithic, which is going to make this wall that much stronger. It would have been strong each pour separate, but we made everything together. So if you can pour monolithic, pour monolithic. Now, you do have to kind of, you know what you guys are doing out there, because if you dig in these piers and they collapse the day you pour and so forth, it can become a issue. So we normally make that call once we get out in the field, see how the soils are, and we make that decision then. So if you're looking for this type of work in the San Francisco Bay Area, Sacramento area, hit us up. All our information is down below here. The angles on this particular project wasn't that too good, because if you look on the other side of this fence, there's just a steep drop here. So I got the best angles I can. I still think you guys will be able to gather some information here and kind of see what it takes to put these walls together. Now, out here in the Bay Area, there's a lot of hills. You got the Oakland Hills, San Jose Hills, San Francisco Hills. So a lot of these pier and gray beam systems are being installed, and we're the ones to do it. So any questions, any comments, leave those down below. Might jump in and out on the video, kind of explain some things if I see needed. Other than that, sit back, relax, enjoy the music. I had a special kind of request for some smooth house music, I guess you'd call it. And house music is actually my favorite type of music, really, especially when I'm working out. Anyway, that's the rant. Check it out. Any questions, comments, again, leave down below. I know I said that three times. Appreciate you guys. We have 18,400 subscribers, trying to get to 19,000 by, let's call it, the end of April. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel, appreciate it if you do. All my day ones, appreciate you, and let's get into it. Right, guys, got a little workout in here with the wheelbarrow patrol here. Probably took about 10 yards of dirt out to the front, a couple yards of concrete, so definitely want to appreciate it. Definitely appreciate them. I just want to jump in here and give them their props, so definitely appreciate it. Continue with the video. Again, any questions, any comments, leave down below. Like, share, comment, all that YouTube algorithm stuff. Watch it to the end. We definitely appreciate you. All right, so when it comes to these piers and rebar cages, I think we got it down packed. We probably have installed, I want to say, 125, over 500 piers for the last year, maybe 2 years. So we definitely got it down packed. So if you're looking to get some pier work, some retaining wall work, that will be us. All the fabrication is done on site. Now, what we did here different, which it's kind of crazy, I just found this out, is that this is a spiral, so it's a continuous rebar that they fabricate at the shop, Biltech, shout out to them, and it's just a spiral, so you can make it where it's 3 inches, 6 inches, or 12 inches, whatever you want to make it on center. So they make it, and you pull it out along the vertical rebars. We use number 6 here. The thing I like about this one, as you guys remember, I'll leave a link down below, when we did this last job up here with this big old deck, they sent us individual circles, and we had to put them on. So that was It went fast because we had these rebar guns, but this is a lot faster. So going forward, I will have them fabricate. They call these spirals, and the other ones are called circles. So I will have them fabricate the spirals. Again, most of them are 3 to 4 inches on center, but you can get them 12 inches. So when you stretch it out, it'll be 12 inches on center. Just want to jump in here, let you guys know our rebar cage work is getting that much more better. Appreciate it. Okay, so all of the piers for the rebar cages was about 14 feet deep, 7 feet on center, 18 inches in diameter. We used 6 number 6 verticals and the number 3 spiral, which was, I believe, was 3 or 4 inches on center. So when you're doing these piers and you're doing these rebar cages, you definitely want to make sure you verify everything with the engineer prior to you ordering and placing them into place here. We was able to lift them all up and in place by hand. Ideally, you can use an excavator or a bobcat, but anything pretty much up to 14 feet, 16 feet. If we don't have a bobcat or an excavator available, we can place by hand. So check out this video. I'll leave a link down below where we installed 27 piers and kind of goes through the process, what it takes to install the piers and rebar cages and so forth. So get back into the video. Appreciate you guys. Alright, so right now we're working on a gray beam here. Ideally, like I said before earlier in the video, you'll pour the piers, you'll pour the gray beam, and you pour the wall, all separate pours. But we kind of figured out how we can pour them all together, which is a monolithic pour, which makes everything that much stronger here. With the piers, we did bring up 4 L's out of the piers that went down about 10 feet deep. We tied that into the gray beam so it can be one continuous structure. And then when we put the rebar, the verticals, those verticals, they tied into the gray beam as well, based on the blueprints that were provided. We added extra support coming out of the pier that makes it that much more stronger, but we did, I think they wanted 3, but we ended up doing 4. So everything worked out perfect. All our verticals, they tie into the gray beam as well here. So this is kind of what it takes to put these type of walls together. So again, if you're in the San Francisco Bay Area, hit us up. Sacramento area, hit us up. Definitely appreciate you guys. Again, it was hard to get that camera in here to get a good angle of us putting this gray beam together, but we have plenty of videos. I'll leave that link down below showing us putting these gray beams together. Appreciate it. All right, guys, here we go, closing up the front here. 2x12s, Doug fir. We use 2x12x16s. One guy can carry that comfortably. 2x12x20, you know, they'll need me out there every day carrying them because I lift weights every day. Nah, I need to, but I don't. Anyway, this is pretty straightforward. Is once you get that first one down, you kind of stack them up, kind of like Legos. Probably every other pour, we'll put some foam wall on the 2x12s that keeps it from sticking against the wall. We kind of use it as we feel needed. But if you're just now getting into this business, you know, the ideal is to get into the practice of using it after every pour, front and back. Now, you don't want to put the backboards up and put the rebar up and you realize you didn't put any oil on them and try to spray the boards with the rebar up, because you will get 1,000 spider cracks. That's just FYI. It happened to me before, but not really. It was at the corner and I kind of remember the guy spraying the foam on all in. It did have some cracks, but that's neither here or there. No one saw it. It was at the corner. It's only a little piece, but do not spray the foam wall on top of the rebar. That's kind of concrete 101, but once we get out in that field, we tend to forget things. So continue checking out the video. We use WT8s on these. These are Simpson ties WT8s. That's what keeps the wall together. And you'll put those, you know, if you're just now doing it for the first time, you'll put them every 12 inches. We just kind of freestyle it and put where we need to. Now, crazy thing about those, a couple of people left a comment saying that you only can use them up to 4 feet. And I'm looking like, well, that's not gonna work. We didn't use them as high as 12 feet. So I guess it depends on the WT12s or 8s or whatever you're using, plus your bracing for the retaining wall. So that's just the FYI. Appreciate you guys checking this out. Any questions, any comments, leave those down below. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, definitely appreciate it. Remember, it's cool to ask for help. Stay positive. And I'll catch you on the next video. Appreciate it. Shortly out of night till morning. Yeah. Shortly out of night till morning.